Okay. I just want to introduce myself. My name is Adam Conlog, and I'm the current president of the Fairfield Kiwanis Club. And I want to thank everyone for coming out tonight, for joining us to celebrate our club's 50th anniversary. A special thank you to our guests who traveled from Des Moines, Iowa City, Sigourney Clubs. Thanks to Jim Dane for coming out. He's our soon-to-be governor of our district. Thanks to Dan for coming out from Washington. And I'd also like to give a special thanks right now to Ron Graves, who's in attendance tonight. He was one of the charter members and the first member on the board of directors when the club was founded in 1965. So without him and our other founding members, we wouldn't even be here tonight. So thank you, Ron, so much for getting this club started. So I've been a member of Kiwanis for 2.5 years, so now I think I moved to Fairfield about 3 years ago. Had no idea what Kiwanis was other than some awesome pancakes once a year at Kids Day. So I didn't really know what I was getting into when I joined. Didn't know I was going to be president this year, so thanks for throwing that on me here. So I did a little, yeah, it's a regular meeting, no pressure here. So I had to do a little research on Kiwanis, so I'm going to bore you all with a history lesson before we have dinner here. Kiwanis was originally founded in Detroit in 1915, so we're also celebrating Kiwanis' 100th anniversary as an organization. Started in Detroit, Michigan, the product of Alan Brown and Joseph Prance, two guys, and it started as a professional networking club. Obviously, Facebook and Twitter weren't getting it done back then, so people actually met face-to-face and talked. Young people today have no concept of what that is. No texting, no Snapchatting, all that. So people face-to-face getting together. Pretty crazy idea. The name Kiwanis is actually derived from an Indian phrase, Nunkiwanis, which means we have a good time, or we make noise, or we share our talents. Our original motto in 1920 was we build, and that's transformed into our motto today, which started in 2005, was serving the children of the world, which I think that's kind of what Fairfield, our club, really has embodied with Kids Day and what we're kind of known for here. Currently, we have 628,000 adult and youth members with over 8,000 clubs. And each year, we've sponsored 150,000 service projects and raised more than $100 million worldwide and 18 million hours of volunteer service. So pretty amazing, I think, what the organization can do and has done, even continuing annually. So the Fairfield Kiwanis Club started back in 1965. The inaugural meeting was December 7th, pretty close to the date here tonight. I had to look this up also. Lyndon Johnson was president in 1965. The number one song on the radio was Wooly Bully. Maybe everybody remembers that one. That's right, that's right. And the number one movie of the year, any guesses? The Sound of Music. Yeah, I didn't know. So the inaugural meeting was held at Parsons College. About 250 members and guests in attendance, pretty impressive. The speaker for that night was Herb Plambeck, governor of the district, of the Nebraska-Iowa district. Apparently he's a pretty big Kiwanian, so I think that was probably a pretty big accomplishment actually back then for the brother clubs. Announcer WHO, so probably tuned in statewide.
Yeah.
Name recognition. There were 34 original charter members. We do have one active charter member. Unfortunately, he's not here tonight. That's Jack Raymond. Everybody, of course, knows Jack. So he's been a very active and great member for our club for 50 years, even though it's hard to see he's even that old. The first president was Jim Maltby. Vice president was Terry Shockley. Secretary was Dale Chase. And treasurer was Ray Hackney. And our charter club directors, along with Ron, were Clarence Adams, William Gerritsen, John Nelson, Robert Bryan, Ivan Rector. And for me, you know, Kiwanis is mostly known as Kids Day. That's what I initially thought. That's pretty much what we did. We just meet one time a year and, you know, cook out pancakes and have a good time and have a parade. But it's really a lot more than that now that I've been involved for a couple of years. And Kids Day was, I guess, the more or less the brainchild of T.L. Henderson. I think all of our club members probably recognize that name in the community. Started in 1967 with taking a group of special education kids on bowling outing. And it progressed on to the next year, 1968 was the very first Kids Day Parade. And from then, it's been pretty much a Fairfield tradition. The high school marching band, people come back just to come to Kids Day. What I think we serve around 2,000 people. I mean, that's 20% of the town. That's pretty impressive, I think, for any event, to get 20% to turn out, really. But aside from Kids Day, you know, we have been involved in a lot of community projects, a lot of stuff that I had no idea we even had sponsored. They start going around town to see Kiwanis here, Kiwanis there, and you see a lot of stuff. And it's hard to get around the community about seeing Kiwanis involved in some way, which I think is really pretty impressive, the impact we've had over the past 50 years. So we've provided funds for projects ranging from equipment at the playgrounds to equipment at the Senior Citizen Center, lighting at the softball field. We just recently contributed to the lighting, the new lighting at the stage at the high school, the new auditorium that they were able to put in. So that's a pretty neat deal that's coming up here. We'll watch a lot of shows up there and make sure we get our minds worth. We've recently donated to purchase band uniforms for the high school. I think it was 20 years ago, they had band uniforms purchased again that we donated to. So apparently the life of band uniforms is 20 years. We've sponsored Little League teams, given the Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts. Every year we award college scholarships to graduating high school seniors as well as non-traditional scholarships. We've given towards projects at the Jefferson County Health Center, the Roosevelt Aquatic Center, the Fairfield Schools, the Fairfield Public Library, numerous other charities, annual contributions every year that kind of go unrecognized, but it's kind of behind the scenes work that we like to keep going, keep supporting these groups. We're also members of Kiwanis International, which is kind of our group's international organization, and our big campaign lately is the Eliminate Project, which is going to raise funds towards eliminating neonatal tetanus. Currently, we've raised $104 million towards a goal of $110 million. I think we've eradicated neonatal tetanus in 100 and some countries or something like that, maybe not that many, but it's...
Yeah, 38.
So oh, 38, okay.
There were 59, and we've knocked 38 off.
Okay, so 38 out of 59 countries have pretty much eliminated neonatal tetanus, so that's pretty impressive. That's a great project that we've been involved in. So, you know, this club has really made a big impact on this community, the state, the country, now, you know, even globally with Kiwanis International. I've certainly enjoyed my time here for the past 2 years. Hopefully I'll be around another 50 for the 100th celebration of our own club. And, you know, it wouldn't be possible to ever be here tonight without our members. We even have some other service clubs in the area. You know, it's clubs like this that really help make a community great and prosperous, brings people in, and it couldn't be, and I think Fairfield too, it couldn't be a greater community to be involved in. I'm an outsider, and I feel like I've been here for 50 years. So, thank you again all tonight. Dinner can be served, or help yourself to the buffet, and have a great time, and our speaker, Steve, we'll introduce him after dinner, and we'll all be mesmerized after. Thank you. All right. Thanks once again, everyone, for coming out tonight. I'm going to go ahead and have our speaker coming up here, and it's Steve Siemens, the people builder. He's also a very active Kiwanis member and was the president of Kiwanis International just a few years ago. So thank you, Steve, for coming on out and coming up.
I am very aware that lots of people celebrate different ways at Christmas time, but I gave you a little handout, so hopefully it's something that you can just enjoy, and whatever your perspective is during this Christmas season, celebrate it in that way. But I always use a handout when I speak. Nothing to write on this one. I'm not taking these home. So you take them home, and there's a few extra if you would like to have some fun. How many of you have heard me speak before? And you still came? I am amazed. Well, tonight for a few minutes, I want to remind us of the gift that we give every day through Kiwanis and the gift that this club has given for the last 50 years in this community. And when you stop and think about 50 years of giving gifts to other people, that's pretty significant. In fact, it's pretty amazing that there's a group of people in Fairfield that are committed to the lives of other people, committed to the children in this community, committed to the adults in this community, who day after day, even though it's not Christmas, give gifts to other people in a very, very special way. There were two ladies that lived in the same town. They were sisters. In fact, they were mean ladies. And they were cheated on their taxes. They were mean to their employees. They were just absolutely mean ladies. One of the sisters died, and so the other sister went to the pastor of the church and said to the pastor, "My sister just died. I would like for you to have her funeral. I only have one request. The one request is at some point in the service, I want you to say, 'My sister was a saint.'" Pastor of the church said, "There's no way I can say that," and starts going through the list. And while he is doing that, she gets out her checkbook, writes out a check for $150,000 made out to the church, holds it up and says, "I'm giving this check to the funeral director. If at some point in the service you say my sister was a saint, your church will get this check." Day of the funeral came, the pastor's up there delivering the service. He said, "Folks, you know this lady was a mean lady. In fact, she's the meanest lady I've ever met in my life. She's mean to her husband, mean to her kids, cheated on taxes, mean to her employees. She was really just a plain mean lady. But as mean as she was, compared to her sister, she was a saint." And when you and I make those unfair comparisons, it always just grinds us down and robs us of the blessings that we can have. And at this time of holiday, Christmas, Hanukkah, whatever you, however you celebrate, there's gifts. And I brought a gift tonight. In fact, this gift has some really pretty cool things in it. And so I want to know who drove the furthest to be here tonight. Well, besides Steve Siemens, I'm getting rid of these things. I'm not taking them home. Over there? How far?
Knoxville.
All right. Well, come on up here, because the gift that I'm going to give you, Mr. Knoxville, is from the Des Moines Airport. It's a paper holder. Oh, with an airplane, you should have flown tonight instead of driven. Good. Who is the youngest person in the room? And you're a member of Fairfield?
I am.
Awesome. Your name?
Ryan Holtz.
Ryan, nice to meet you. You need to drink lots of water. Who has the most children?
Legitimate?
Yes, legitimate. Four? Who has five? Who has more than five? Anybody? All right, just one person has five? Anyone else have more than? All right, Mr. Knoxville, you win again. Come on up here. You should have had a school bus having all those kids. So there you go.
Can I just say that this is a hard time of the year for me, because 8 years ago I lost one of mine. I lost my daughter to cancer. So I'm glad to be here.
Well, absolutely. And that does make life pretty fun. All right. Who's the best looking person in the room?
Steve Sabins.
You are.
No. I'm sorry. Oh, Jim Dane? All right, Jim Dane, come on up here. In fact, it was a tie. Come on up here. There's a lady in the back of the room that's the nicest looking person in the room. Come, please. Jim, come. I went to a holiday party, got this as a gift. I have no idea what's in it, but it's yours. And since you are the most beautiful person, I gave you a...
That was easy
button. That's very easy. See how easy that was? And I think we ought to give the president this timer because his timing tonight has been exquisite.
I'll set it for 7 o'clock sharp.
There you go. Can you imagine life without Kiwanis?
No.
Can you imagine Fairfield without Kiwanis? And for the last 50 years, every day, there's been a group of people that have come together and just simply given gifts. And there's some gifts in here that money will never buy, because what I gave you tonight was stuff that was given or re-gifted. It's stuff that will wear out. It's stuff that will be broken. It's stuff that will not last very long. And I want to remind all of us tonight that the gift that you give every day through Kiwanis is something that's going to live when you and I are gone because of a group of people committed to make life better for people. And the first gift that I pull out of this box that is going to live forever is what you have modeled for the last 50 years, and you have given the gift of leadership. And what I want to do tonight as we go through this presentation is I want to give you a chance to help create the story tonight that we're going to talk. And I want you to share who are some leaders from this club, or if we have visiting clubs as well, you can share. But who are some leaders over the last 50 years in this context tonight that have really made a difference in your life? And when I ask you a question, I'm just going to give you a chance to holler out some of the names of those people. Because the last 50 years, not only have you had great leadership, but you've developed great leadership, a gift that makes a huge difference. Who are some leaders?
Yeah. Kurt Hansen.
Bob Brown.
Jeff Johnston. Pete Dolanera.
Dick Bogner.
John Roloff.
T.L. Henderson.
Isn't that cool? People that have stood behind the microphone, people that have stood behind the podium and made such a difference in our lives. For 7 or 9 years, I was president of Iowa Christian College in Des Moines. One day at the college, a man calls up, says, "Want to talk to the big hog at the trough?" My secretary said, "Pardon me?" He said, "Want to talk to the big hog at the trough?" She goes, "Sir, we don't talk that way around here, and I think I know who you want to talk to. You change your terminology and put you through. If not, you're not talking to him." He said, "I want to talk to the big hog." She said, "Sir, he is a little overweight, but we don't talk about him that way. You call him Mr. Siemens, President Siemens, or Steve will put you through. If not, you're not talking to him." He said, "I want to talk to the big hog." She said, "Sir, you're not listening to me." He said, "No, you're not listening to me." He said, "I'm a pig farmer out here in Northwest Iowa. I just sold my hogs. Want to give $100,000 to the college." She said, "Just a minute. The big pig just walked in." And for the last 50 years, you've had some big hogs at the trough that have made a difference. And aren't you glad for that? Say yes.
Yes.
And every one of us have been blessed by leaders that inspire us, encourage us to greatness, and never forget this. Unless you're the lead dog, the scenery never changes. The second gift is the gift of giving. Think of the hours that this club has given to this community and to the people in this community. I don't always have time to give my time, and you probably don't either. I don't always have time to give or I don't think I have time to give, but every time that I do, I'm always blessed, and so are you. And for the past 50 years, there have been some community-minded people in this community that have gotten up every morning not to receive, but to give, and have made a part of their daily or weekly activity making life better for other people. What are some experiences that you have enjoyed in this club through the giving of things that really stick in your mind?
Kids Day.
Kids Day? What else?
Meet people at Old Threshers.
Old Threshers Day, okay. What else?
Watching Amish kids play on the spiral slide with Whitmer
Harbor. All right, watching honor kids play on the spiral slide.
Amish kids, yeah.
Oh, Amish kids, I'm sorry. Play on the spiral slide that you put in the park, cool. What else?
Helping boys get football shoes that can't afford it.
Helping boys get football shoes that can't afford, isn't that nice? I mean, just think about that.
Watching the Little League that we sponsor.
Okay, watching the Little League that you sponsor. And because of you and the gift of giving, you and I have been reminded that the more you give, the more you live. Every Thanksgiving, we decorate the inside of our house for Christmas, eat pizza, and serve Meals on Wheels. I'll do that till I die. Nothing wrong with a big to-do on Thanksgiving, but we just decided on Thanksgiving, we're going to be reminded of how blessed we have been and just give back to people. And so we eat pizza, decorate the inside of our house, and serve Meals on Wheels. Pizza tastes the best on Thanksgiving Day. The more you give, the more you live. Every 4th of July, we go caroling in a care facility. We used to sing Christmas songs until the administrator asked us to change. It was confusing several residents, so we don't sing Christmas anymore, but we sing all the way from Papa down to little granddaughter, just walk up and down the hallway singing every 4th of July. Why? Because we bombard care facilities in December, and we forget about them the rest of the year. We sing the best on the 4th of July. Why? The more you give, the more you live. And my friends, you and I are going to be remembered for what we gave, not what we received. Your gift of giving for the last 50 years has changed lives. You give the gift of service. You know, you can spell the word service two ways. The way I have it up here, S-E-R-V-I-C-E, or you can spell it S-U-R-V-E space U-S. And there's two ways to spell this word. And when you and I spell it in not serve us, but spell it in service, the things that you do in Kids Day, the things that you do in the community every day that are a reflection of your service is a gift that money will never buy and a gift that makes a huge difference in the lives of other people. Projects. Adam did a great job of talking about all the projects that you do day, week after week, or year after year. Things that, isn't it amazing how we get tired of projects? Say yes. Let's just be honest. And at times it's almost like pulling teeth and pulling hair to get people to do. And yet in the big picture of everything, you and I, these are the things that make such a difference in the lives of kids. These projects. And we forget it's not flipping pancakes, it's changing lives. We forget it's not building a playground, it's changing lives. We forget at times that these projects are the things that make this club unique and made all of us better people because of the things that we've done in the gift of projects. Another gift, youth. How many old people are here tonight? Just what I thought, there's not any old people here tonight. You know why? Because old is an attitude. I have people all the time saying to me, well, how do you define success? My definition of success is very easy. At age 4, it's not peeing in your pants. At age 12, it's having friends. 16, it's having a driver's license. 20, it's believing you are sexy. 35, it's having money. 50, it's having money. 60, it's believing you are sexy. 70, it's having a driver's license. 75, it's having friends. And 80, it's not peeing in your pants. So keep that in mind if you want to define success. But my goal in life is to die young as late as possible. And I will tell you, my friends, even though I'm only 63 years old, and some of you are older than that, I still stay young every time I'm around those kids. Key Club, Builders, Cape Kids, doesn't make any difference. And I'm committed to stay young in my thinking. How many of us still jump in mud puddles? There was two hands. How many of us still play with cardboard boxes? Isn't it sad that we grow up and get old? And the gift that you give to those young people every day make a difference, but it keeps us young in what we do and in how we do it. The gift of friendships. I have said this often and will say it probably till I die, but I would have never met the people I have met had it not been through Kiwanis. There are lifelong friends in Des Moines, Iowa that I would go to the top of the mountain and support in any way, shape, or form, just like you have some friends in Fairfield or Iowa City or Sigourney or wherever you come from, that you would do the same. And it's been because of that bond of Kiwanis. Now, I've had the privilege to serve as the international president, and the, quite frankly, one of the humbling things in my life right now is I could go anywhere in the world and only be a phone call away from a Kiwanian. That's pretty amazing. And I don't care where it would be in the world if I was in trouble, I'm only a phone call away from somebody like-minded that would do whatever they can to help or make a difference. I just cannot imagine life without friends. And one of the things that makes Kiwanis really cool, and one of the benefits of being a Kiwanian, is friendship. And one of the gifts that you as a club have given to each other for the last 50 years, and one literally for 50 years, is friendship. My wife said to me last night, she said, "Steve, will you love me when my hair turns gray?" Said, "Well, I don't know why not. I've loved you through 14 other colors." And the bottom line is, you and I just are in an organization that allows us to build friendships with each other, and regardless of our hair color, just really develop that friendship and every day give the gift of friendship. Who are some friends in this club that have really made a difference in your life?
Pretty much everybody in our organization has made a difference in my life. Several of them, a lot here in the last 3 or 4 months during one of our biggest projects. And I appreciate their friendship, and I know that any of them would do anything for me just as I would for them.
Who else has some specific names? Sure you can. I understand that. And I appreciate that. But there's just some people that you just, aren't you better because you've met these people? And I never ever thought that when I started Kiwanis 30 plus years ago that I would develop friendships that just were as meaningful as they are today, as important as they are today. And one of the gifts that we give every time we get together is just that gift of friendship. Others?
Martin Scepter.
Say it again.
Martin Scepter.
Okay. You know, we sat at their table. They're kind of nice people.
One who isn't here, Jeff Northridge.
Yes.
Lynn Morrison is his friend of mine, not here.
Cool.
Jerry Thompson.
Please.
I'm not in the Kiwanis group. I just have a husband that is. But there's a member that's been a good member, a good serving member, a hardworking member for a lot of years, and he's not capable of being participating anymore. In the last couple of years, that when he started not being able to do things on his own, these guys picked him up and took him out and found something for him to do and kept him a part of it.
Mm-hmm.
And I was so proud of him.
Isn't that a blessing?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Friendship. Have you ever thought of Kiwanis as a gift? Some people join Kiwanis for networking. Some people join Kiwanis because they want to give back to the community. Some people join Kiwanis because their employer says they have to be a part of a service club. I mean, there's all kinds of reasons why people join. But have you ever thought that Kiwanis is really a gift? And every day as Kiwanians, and I think we have other service club members here, whether you're a Lion or Rotarian, doesn't make a difference. It's the same for all of us. Every day, you and I are giving gifts. It's not a meeting. It's not a fundraiser. It's not a ticket to sell. It's not a banquet to attend. It's a gift. And for the last 50 years, this club and we as Kiwanians have been in giving gifts. Life is made of memories. My mother lost her battle with cancer about 22 years ago, and she lived in Joplin, Missouri at the time, and my two brothers and I would go down to Joplin and spend time with her. She went through five surgeries and fought it for about 3 years, finally lost that battle. But you know what we talked about in the hospital room? Memories. We didn't talk about all the stuff that we talk about lots of times. We talked about the remembering, the memories that we had. And every one of us tonight, if I would give you an opportunity, have so many Kiwanis memories that you and I could spend the rest of our night talking about just some memories that have made Kiwanis. Well, I want to tell you something, my friends. Memories are a gift. And when you and I understand that, we understand it most when we're going through a tough time in our lives or we're going through a challenging time in our lives and we remember back to some of the gifts that people have given to us over that lifetime. And one more little gift that we give every meeting is just plain fun. My 97-year-old grandfather used to live 3 hours from Des Moines. He would drive old people to Des Moines to the hospital. If you were not old when you left Goldfield, Iowa, you would be old when you got to Des Moines. He drove like a maniac. I wouldn't even back out of the driveway with the man, but he'd call up every once in a while, wants to have coffee, said he had to bring another old person to Des Moines to the hospital. We live east of Des Moines in the country. I have a good friend in Des Moines who was 104 at that time. She wanted to drive a bulldozer. When she was 100, she wanted to drive a bulldozer, and so I have a friend in Des Moines who's a contractor. He brought out a Caterpillar, and we put her on the thing at 100 years old. She pulled levers, made a mess, but she drove a bulldozer. She's 102, learned some German, 103, learned some French, 104, she wanted to go bungee jumping with me. She would have done it in a minute. She would have died in the process, but she'd say, what a way to go. She had a simple little philosophy of life. My grandpa has it, and I've got it. It goes like this: don't die until you're dead. Is it amazing the number of dead people that are walking around today? Say yes.
Yes.
Is it amazing the number of dead people you know? Say
yes.
And if you and I are not careful, you know why we lose that enthusiasm? You know why we lose that zest for life? Because we stop giving gifts. And so every morning for the last 50 years, the Kiwanians in this community have gotten up with maybe not this goal even thought about, but you've gotten up to be a blessing to other people. You've come to meetings to give the gift of service or just plain giving. You've taken on those projects. You've created those memories. You have provided that service. You have given people a chance to develop in leaders or in leadership and to grow leaders. You've had fun in the process doing it, but it's been a tremendous gift. And you and I need to understand that every day we have the opportunity to do some amazing things through an organization that's called Kiwanis. So for 50 years, 50, you've been given gifts. You've been given people an opportunity to grow as leaders. You've instilled hope in the lives of kids. You've given them self-esteem by buying shoes. You flip pancakes. Gifts. Have you thought of that? They're not projects. They're not requirements. They're gifts. And at a time when we give gifts to other people, we spend lots of money buying things that will rust, that will break, that will wear out. In fact, we even spend money giving gifts that will be regifted. We think they're cool, but the person that gets it doesn't think that. And for a few minutes tonight, I wanted to remind us that as an organization of Kiwanians, a group of simply service-minded people, we have come to meetings and we have come to events and we have come to a community to give gifts. Gifts that will never die, never wear out, and you can't buy. So tonight, thank you for the leadership that this club's given for the last 50 years. Thank you for the projects that you have done the last 50 years. Thank you for the service that you can give and continue to give for the last 50 years. Thank you for the memories that you have created the last 50 years. Thank you for all of the things that you have done that you can't buy with money, things that will never ever wear out, things that have changed the lives of people in this community. And because of that, what you and I do in Kiwanis is worth our time. It's worth our money, it's worth our energy, and it's worth everything that we have to give. And so my encouragement tonight is the next 50 years, what gifts will you continue to give? And what will you continue to do that will make a difference in the lives of other people? I've had some pretty amazing experiences in my Kiwanis journey. One of them was sitting in Haiti on a dirt floor with five children, a mom and a dad. Three of those kids severely mentally challenged, two of them completely healthy. The difference? Several years ago, we had an international program that iodized the salt of people, and the mother had salt in her body that was iodized the last two pregnancies and had two completely healthy children. Because a group of people in Fairfield gave gifts. You and I have been blessed to be a blessing. You and I have been given an opportunity to make a difference in the lives of other people. And tonight, for a few minutes, I wanted to just remind us that you and I have a chance to give gifts to other people through an organization that we love called Kiwanis. And because of that, the world's a better place. And Fairfield is a better place. And you and I are better people. Because the more you give, the more you live. Happy anniversary. And may us as Kiwanians and as people continue giving the gifts that continue giving.
Thank you, Steve. That was excellent. Thanks for the speech and for everyone that's been here. Thank you. Let's have another great 50 years. I'd ring the bell, but it's hidden, so I'll just go ahead and say meeting adjourned for tonight. But please stay, have a good time, and thanks to all, everyone for coming out.